Today I am trying out the Saiboku Shimbi ink sticks from Kuretake. This is my first time experimenting with colored ink sticks, so I'm curious to see how they work and how I can apply them to my painting style. A big thank you to Kuretake for sponsoring this video. The ink sticks come individually packed in tiny wooden boxes to preserve them from moisture and light. They are also wrapped in washi paper. There are 12 colors, including really vibrant primary colors and some green and earthy tones. There's also white ink and two different tones of black, one with blue undertone and the other with red. The package comes with short instructions on how to use the inks, and a color guide with actual samples of each ink in varying opaqueness. I also received an inkstone from them, and I'll be trying some of their brushes as well. Since the ink sticks are solid, the idea is to grind a preferred amount of paint from the stick with the help of some water and an inkstone. Once I have enough paint, I pour it into the well and place it onto my ceramic paint palette. To store the ink stick, I wipe it dry and put it back into its box. Even though the package came with the color guide, I wanted to see how the inks feel in action. So I sketched a few small drawings, which I'm using to try the inks. The colors are nice and vibrant, and I feel that they work very much like watercolors, but they are a bit more opaque. At this point, I think I'm ready to move forward to painting a bigger piece with the inks. For this piece, I am making the sketch with a pink colored pencil. I am using my go-to cotton watercolor paper for this painting. I think these inks would definitely work wonderfully on Japanese paper, but this is what I'm most comfortable working with. Before I start to paint, I cover all the petals and the flowers with masking fluid. The scent of the inks is very nostalgic to me for some reason. It has this earthy, forest floor kind of smell. Reminds me of summer. I am really enjoying the process of making my own inks. It is somehow really calming. The ink takes a good while to dry, which gave me lots of time to work on this large area. I'm really happy with how the first layer of background paint came out, with the nice and smooth upper area, and how the character's hair looks underwater. Once the ink is dry on the paper, it doesn't lift too easily with water, which allows me to make multiple passes in the same spot without getting blurred areas. The highlights for this painting were made with a brush pen white ultra fine from Kuretake. Here's the finished piece. I hope you enjoyed the process, and thank you again, Kuretake, for collaborating with me.